If you could tell your pet one thing that he, she would understand, what would it be? Pissing on the carpet when I'm looking away is still bad. Just because I didn't see it, doesn't mean it didn't happen. You don't have to panic and destroy the house when we leave. We will be back. We love you and would never abandon you. You need to stop scratching, biting, and licking yourself. You're only making it worse. All of this medicine I'm giving you is to help you feel better. If I die suddenly, I just want her to know I didn't desert her. When I leave her with my boyfriend, he says every time he comes back home, she gets sad, disappointed that it's not me. It breaks my heart thinking she'll feel this way for the rest of her life if something happens to me. I wish I could tell him, it's gonna be okay, and he would understand. Every time my parents leave the house he gets real upset and starts panicking. I wish I could tell him he can calm down. On a different note, he knows what kiss means. It's okay. We'll be okay. We love you so much and we'll be okay. You can let go now. She's getting slower and her step is getting heavier each day. But her will to live is strong. Your mother and I are living apart. I know that seems stupid, but we weren't very smart. You'll stay with her. I'll visit you at Christmas. On weekends. The summertime too, after living together for 3 years. My so and I broke up. It was very calm and as amicable as it could be, but she has more room for our little Aussie. I wish I could tell him that he did nothing wrong and I would take him with me if I could. I have 3 cats. 2 are quite intelligent. The other is not so bright. My late father was their primary caregiver and he died in bed. The smart ones seemed to understand that he had gone. They cried for days. I believe my boy does not know he has gone for good and will not come back. He tries to escape into the hallway and he never did this before my dad's death. I think that was the last place he caught his scent, so he thinks my dad is out there. I just want him to know that his friend is gone and that he'll see him again someday. I will never forget the warm summer days where we would nap together under a tree. You were a good boy. Where did the onions come from? I know this is confusing for you. But just because I'm the most playful with you doesn't mean that I'm always playing tag. I want to cuddle too. He does cuddle with me. By the way, but when he's hyper, always, he will run and have me chase him and then chase me. I'm like, let me love you, sad face. I wish I could take better care of you. I'm sorry I can't get out of bed some days. Stop pretending to wee when you are outside so you can come back in. I can see that you're not actually weeing. As soon as you wee, you can come back in. I know you need to go. Would have wanted to tell my cat how much I loved her. Too late now. She died 20 days ago. I'm not going to eat you. I promise. So please let me cuddle you. I have skittish guinea pigs. When I stand on your foot, I don't mean it and I feel terrible. When I put you in the cat carrier and take you to the airport next year, it's because we're leaving the country together and going back home. I don't want to lose you. So don't worry. I would tell my kitten to stop trying to commit suicide by chewing on electrical cords in the house. He's 5 months old and teething. So I've covered all of the cords with bitter apple. But that doesn't seem to always stop him. For the last time, can you stop eating the god roast chicken? Phoebe, I love you and you are the bestest, sweetest kitty in all the world. I realize you never really learned how to cat. But honey, your butt needs to be in the box too, not just your head. Getting into street fights costs mommy a lot of money and heartache. And mommy loves you too much to see you die of getting beat up by a random fluffy cat. And that's why you really have to stay inside at night. Lol. Stop eating plastic. We will not feed you fresh liver every day. Get used to normal cat food. I'm allowed to keep my sock on my foot. Please stop nibbling. Everything I've ever done to you was for you. Medications are the worst. They just don't understand why you're jamming down their throats. Giving them needles. Giving them eye drops or rubbing in their ears. No, I'm not giving you food. You already got food. I'm here because I needed to be in the kitchen. Why are you trying this again after 5 minutes? I don't have any food. I just wanted to pet you. I'd want to say I love you, but I feel like it would be more useful to say, please don't outside of your litter box ever. You have 2. Just pick one and in it. My pug has separation anxiety. I'd tell him that we will never abandon him and that we always come back cause he is our family. We adopted him at 8 years old cause his owner did not want him anymore. That I'm sorry I moved away and couldn't take him with me. But he's still got my parents. We could have a lot more fun. And go a lot more places if you weren't such a runaway. Husky Mix. Loves to run away. Even though he has an awesome life. When you sleep on the heat vent. The rest of the room gets cold. I would tell my cat that she's supposed to cover her with the sand in the box. Not by trying to scratch up the floor. We don't have much time. Tap your right paw on the ground once for yes. Left paw twice for no for any future questions I ask. Three times means you want to go out. Tap my leg gently for I want pats, cuddling. And four taps for I want food. You know what? Forget that last one. You always want food. Five taps on the ground as I don't feel well. Got it? Do you like me? Be honest. You can say I'm a complete bloody if you want to. I'm routinely grabbing you and forcing your eyes open to drop strange clear fluid onto your eyeballs to help you. God damn it. You'll be better sooner if I do this. I'm moving out of my parents' house cross country and I want to tell my two girls that I love them and won't forget about them. And that I'll be back to visit. I love him very much. Kind of corny. But I really care about him. Please meow more. I have no clue what you're telling by staring at me all the time. I know you don't like the shower. But the more you struggle and run around while I'm trying to wash and dry you, the longer you'll be there. Please just sit still and get it over with. That she's a good girl and I'm sorry if I've made her sad. And she's my best friend and I love her so much. I know she's a dog but she's the best thing in my life, TT. Why I have to shut him in a small box and take him to the vet periodically. It traumatizes him. I can't hug every cat. But I chose to hug you. Life isn't all about ball. Please stop. Stop being a to other animals. Other dogs out of walks are friends. Not enemies. When you see I'm wearing black pants. Don't rub up against me. She's no longer with me. But I tried so hard to tell her that the pills I was forcing down her throat would help her get better. I need you more than you need me. Red heart. It's okay to let me pet the cat. It doesn't mean I love you less. You don't have to come break up the party just because I'm showing some love for your sister. I love you. Too. You both get scritches. Dogs can be so jealous and possessive. Oh my god. That I don't stick her with needles to hurt her or to be mean. I do it to keep her alive because I love her. I feel so guilty every time I have to give her an injection because I know she doesn't understand. You don't need to worry so much about the parents going out. They will always come back just fine. You also make me very happy sometimes. Although clearly you don't seem to care as much about me as I do you since after all. I am not the one who raised you. And through my childhood I see how I have annoyed you. Sorry for that. Really. Also. Don't worry about other dogs or people so much. They don't want to hurt you most of the time and just wanna pet you and whatnot. I really want you to experience these things and you being aggressive to everyone other than friends, family gets kind of hard to deal with grinning face with sweat love y'all. Furball. The vacuum isn't trying to murder you. I'm just collecting all the fur that you shed. Not my cat, but my roommates. The kitchen counters are not for you to jump on. While there may be delicious food up there sometimes, it will almost certainly make you sick if you try eating it. Stop knocking pans or containers of food when your owner literally fed you an hour ago. I would have told my dog that I love her more than anything and that she's the best stuff a girl could have ever wished for. And of course that she is exactly as pretty as she believes she is and therefore deserves all the bells, scratches and cookies. I lost her in December after 12 years and I still don't know what I'm supposed to do without her. You are safe and loved here. To the rescues. TP my cat. Stop being a dot and for THR love of cat Jesus leave the toilet paper alone. Be home at 8, we don't want you out overnight. It sucks and WRRE worried every time, cat. You aren't allowed outside anymore because you have a disease that could kill you if you do. It's not because we hate you. We want you to stay happy and healthy BC we love you. You need to understand that you're getting older and that you aren't able to do the things you did 10 years ago. This doesn't mean you're not a good girl and I love you. But know your limits, you old girl. Stop pissing on the floor. Go outside to do it. Stop waking me up in the morning. I love you but I want to sleep in. I will spend time with you in a few hours. I love how 50% of this thread is, I love you so much and you're my everything, and the other 50% is, you little you better stop everywhere, but to answer the question. I know we get on each other's nerves. But you're my everything. I love you more than I love anyone in this world. And the only thing I don't like about you is how short your life expectancy is. I wish we could grow old together and never have to live without each other. I dread the day that I lose you. But at the same time, I know I'll be happy just knowing that I got to spend so much time with you. You've helped me through the hardest times of my life and you don't even realize it. I love you, baby girl, and you're my best friend. Ah, op, you've got me crying. I haven't cried in weeks.